This is going to be a quick video, a message to Andrew Yang. It is debate night, and I just want to let you know that, of course, we were all disappointed in Iowa. I know that you were. I expected much higher, especially with all the time and money that was invested. It's the simple fact that the media is just not covering you. It's nothing you're doing. It's the media. They're not covering you. The DNC is working in conjunction with them. We know what the game is. They're propping up Klobuchar. They're propping up now Buttigieg. And it's just been weeks and months of the same thing. So anybody from the outside, they're not going to let in. So what we need to do is we need to give them what they want. You need to go on offense today. Now, I know that's not your style. And I'm not saying get nasty and, you know, mean like the others do, but go after them on policy, because I know that you disagree with them on policy. I would say that we should go after Bernie. People are confused and think that you and Bernie are the same, and you're not. You're drastically different. Basically, it's kind of like what you say about you and Trump. You two have identified the problems correctly, but the solutions are completely different. Introducing socialism, socialist policies, democratic socialism, into an economy that is facing mounting automation is a terrible idea. The funding's not there. The funding mechanisms, we know they're hollow. They're not going to be able to pay for the programs that he is offering. And we need to call that out. And I think that a key word is socialism. And if you use that during the debate, you are going to spark a real conversation of ideas in a debate, something that we have seen very little of since, of course, the CNN debate, where they were actually talking about automation. But what we need is we need media mentions. We need media attention. And to rightfully call out bad policy is not a bad thing. And we need the media attention. So if you mention socialism and the fact that you disagree with it, and we're still arguing about the dichotomy between socialism and capitalism, it's silly. The whole economy is changing, and we know that. Many people don't understand that. Many people don't understand that we don't need to be having this conversation, that we need to, like you say, kind of use the best ideas of both worlds. It's a new game, and we need new rules, and we can write those new rules. But to go after a federal jobs guarantee when machines and AI are going to be able to do jobs, and to offer a $15 federal minimum wage when there's less available jobs, these programs don't make sense. You have better ideas than the others. And we need to put that on display. And by calling them out directly, by, you know, with their policy, that's how we're going to get the attention that you need. Once you get the attention, and once people learn what you are about, you're a shoo-in. If you bring up that there's three options on the table in the Democratic field right now. One is socialism, democratic socialism. Two is the status quo. Three is you. We just need to bring up the fact that you and Bernie are drastically different. And this will cause a back and forth between you and Bernie tonight. And the media play is going to be very helpful for you. You need to get on the airwaves. You need to have people talking about you. You need to have people looking into you. Once they do, you got them. And that's what we need. We need remedies for this country, and we're not going to get it if we continue to not engage, not play the game that they have set up. And it's just clear that we have to play the game if we want to win this. Now, I know you have it in you. I've seen you in the earlier times. The way you dismantled Varney, I mean, it was beautiful. You basically called him a dumbass with your eyes. It was fantastic.
Total socialism. socialism, and you're smart enough to know this, socialism is when is when a country nationalizes the means of production.
This is pro-market and pro-consumer.
Yes, very much so.
And that's the, to me, that's the kind of Andrew that we need to see in the debates. It will land. It will land well. And you'll get the media attention that you need. The media at this point is saying that Iowa is over. Everything is confused. The winners aren't going to get the bump. The losers aren't going to get the negativity that you normally would. And basically, New Hampshire is the new Iowa. So now New Hampshire is kind of like Iowa and New Hampshire rolled into one. And honestly, I think this day is going to be our make or break moment. And I sure as hell hope you make it. Please get aggressive, you know, nicefully, of course, humanity first. But I know you have it in you. I've seen it when you debated the libertarians. You were fantastic. You know, you don't always have to be the nice, sweet, gentle guy. You can be the smartest guy in the room, and that's okay. You can let people know that, by what you're telling them, and, you can speak through people. You can speak over people. Again, I've seen you do that. And it works.
I just wonder how many people will vote for a 10% sales tax across America.
How many people will vote for $1,000 in their pockets and the pockets of everyone in their family and everyone in their neighborhood? That's really the question.
And I certainly hope that you can bring that game tonight, because I don't want this to end. I want you to be president. And I just want to say that I'm proud, proud as hell of you. You've done a great job. You've gotten so far, and I would just hate to see us on the decline if we don't perform well today in the debate.
Oh, I dream of these people every night. The only thing I worry about is that some total unknown that nobody ever heard of comes along.